Solar electricity panels can earn you thousands of pounds under the government's Clean Energy Cashback Scheme, but only if your roof is right. So, when companies come round to sell you solar panels, do they really know what they're talking about? Which has conducted an undercover investigation into solar companies and found some pretty dodgy sales tactics, which could leave consumers losing out. I'm here with Home Editor Liz Edwards. So Liz, what did we look at in our investigation?
Well, lots of companies, including big names like British Gas and Anglian, have started selling solar panels since the government introduced its Clean Energy Cashback Scheme, which is also called the feed-in tariff. And under the feed-in tariff, you can earn money from generating electricity from green sources like solar panels. We estimate that you could earn yourself £28,000 profit over 25 years under the scheme.
Wow, certainly sounds good.
That's right. I mean, it's generated a lot of interest from people. And so to protect consumers, the government has said that if you want to earn this money, you have to use a certified installer and certified products. So what we did was invited 12 companies, all of them certified, round to our house, an undercover house. And because the scheme bans pressure selling, we were looking to see whether they were going to try and give us the hard sell.
So what did we find? Did we see any examples of hard selling?
We absolutely did. Out of the 12 companies, two quite clearly breached the code on in terms of their sales practices. So Skyline put us under a fair bit of pressure to sign up quickly. Green Sun gave us just 24 hours to sign a deal for £10,000.
So I understand we've got a clip of this. Let's take a look at the salesman in action.
You put all this in writing for me on the post?
I can put the 10942 05 in writing to you.
Right.
I can't put the discounted one in.
Why is that then?
It's unavailable to somebody.
Okay.
Not my rules. I don't put discounts on for one reason. And that's to get people business.
Yeah, certainly.
Yeah, it's just worth, it's a discount of £1,378.
Alright, okay. Do that and I'll go standard. So next day or so.
Yeah, and to be quite honest, I'm only working tomorrow morning and that's me done. So, effectively, but what I didn't, I'd need to know by either end of today or tomorrow, at the latest, to come and get the paperwork sorted out because I go back north on Sunday.
Okay.
And the show finishes then anyway.
Yeah.
So
we've reported that company to the certification scheme.
And what about the Skyline salesman?
Well, the Skyline salesman offered us a discount if we were willing to give him meter readings regularly. This is specifically banned under the code because it's a spurious reason for giving a discount. He also put us under pressure because he said it was a first-come, first-served discount, which implies you better hurry up and take it or I'm going to give it to someone else.
How does that sound to you?
Well, yeah, it sounds fine. I just want to know the price.
What I'm going to ask you is a simple question. If you were to offer you a price that you're happy with, is this something that you go ahead with me now?
If the price, well, then I can't really say, can I? Do I know what the price is? I mean, I don't.
Well, yeah, there's only two answers to that. Is that going to be, when I give you the price, there's only two answers that possible. It's either going to be yes, let's go ahead, or no, thank you, here's the door. But what I tell you is, on that system here, if you were to go ahead with me now, we could have you to it for £10,238.
Right.
Which is quite a bit cheaper than 11,136.
Mm-hmm. And that's 10,000 plus you want me to do the meter readings as well, you're saying?
Yeah, but the meter readings takes 10 seconds a month.
Mm.
Okay? So if you want to do that, 10,238 includes everything. Includes VAT, fitting, the locks, nothing else to pay. All right? Mm-hmm. Otherwise, I'll give you the price of £11,156.
So we've also reported that company to the certification scheme.
So apart from these dodgy sales tactics, did we uncover any other issues?
Yes, hidden costs. So if you're shelling out a lot of money for solar panels, you want to know about all the costs that are involved. And with solar panels, you need to have an inverter, which is the thing that changes the power that's generated by the solar panels into usable current, AC current, in your home. And that needs to be replaced about every 10 years, and it costs £1,000. Now, 10 out of the 12 companies didn't even mention it.
So, we've got another clip of Green Sun here. What's going on here?
Well, our researcher is prompting the salesman about ongoing costs, and she does that several times, but he doesn't mention the really obvious one, which is this.
Do you get any problems once you put the panels on? Is there any, like,
no, because there's no moving parts.
No.
So once the panels are up there, that's it. Just fit it and forget it.
There's no maintenance or ongoing costs? Nothing?
No. Okay. No annual servicing or anything like that, because there's effectively nothing to actually...
But you get, like, what I'm saying as well, do you get, like, problems at all once you've got them up, sort of thing? Then?
No, there shouldn't be any. I mean,
she really did give him every opportunity there, didn't she?
Yes.
And I understand we also had a problem with the people that the companies were sending to do the quotes.
That's right. This is not about dodgy selling tactics, but it is about salespeople. Because as far as we're concerned, some of these companies are sending a salesperson to do a surveyor's job. Now, if you're getting a quote from a builder, they don't send the marketing manager to do the quote. They send the builder, because he or she's got the technical knowledge to know how much something's going to cost and whether it's going to work in your home. But half the companies that we tested sent a salesperson, which would be followed up by a surveyor's visit, but you're being asked to make the decision on the salesperson's visit. And that could potentially be an inaccurate quote, because the surveyor's quote is likely to be more accurate. And one of the companies that did that was Anglian.
Yes, and Anglian's our final clip. What's going on here?
Well, here, the salesperson is explaining why he's not really qualified to quote.
I just want to, does it cause any damage or anything to the roof?
No, we don't. Everything's got to be, everything's subject to survey. So right. It's got to be surveyed. And if the roof has got like a, you know, if it's not perfectly what I call flat, we can't build on it.
Right.
So we would structurally survey it. I'm not a surveyor.
Right.
So get another man round. He goes up in the loft and says, yeah, it's structurally sound and it can take the weight of the panels.
Okay.
Otherwise, as a big national company, we wouldn't take the job on anyway.
So it looks like there's some serious issues with these companies who are asking consumers to part with thousands of pounds.
That's right. All in all, we found some pretty shocking things. We don't see why people should be put under pressure to buy something that costs a lot of money. And we don't see why a surveyor shouldn't be sent the first visit. Why people should be asked to make a decision on potentially quite an inaccurate quote from a salesperson. So we're talking to the government and we're talking to the industry and we're going to be pushing for change.
Thanks, Liz. For more information on this investigation or for buying advice if you're considering getting solar panels, visit which.co.uk.